Okay, so you're probably looking at the screen and wondering who in the world are these four men that I have put on the screen. Well, these four men we're going to look at are very important in understanding theories of development. So that's what we're going to talk about in this video, are the different theories of development. And it would be nice if I could spell it properly. There we go. Okay. So up here we have Freud. Over here we have Erikson. Over here is Vygotsky. And last we have Kohlberg. So development, let's start off by defining what it is. Development is the series of age-related changes that happen over the course of a lifespan. So people pass through different stages in a specific order, and each stage builds on top of another. And we develop capacities through those stages, built upon the previous stage. So these four men had four different theories of how we develop. And the first we're going to take a look at is Freud, Sigmund Freud. So Freud proposed the psychosexual theory of development. So let's write that down here. So he was important in starting off the psychosexual theory that describes how personality develops during childhood. It's also another key term. He looked at how we develop through childhood, and he actually believed that early childhood was the most important age or period in which most of our personality is developed. He said that most of our personality is established by the age of 5. And he says that early experiences play a large role in personality development, and that continues to influence behavior later in life. And his theory was built upon 5 stages, which we'll get into a little bit later. But if these 5 stages are completed successfully, the result is a healthy personality. And certain issues, if they're not resolved at a certain stage, and we move ahead to the next stage, then something called fixation can happen. So that's another key term that we'll take a look at a little later. So that's the psychosexual theory of Freud. Now the second key player or key person that we're going to look at was Kohlberg. Erikson. And Erikson talked about the psychosocial development theory. So in this theory, Erikson proposed that personality development occurs through one's entire lifespan. So you can already see how it's a little different from Freud, who said personality, most of it's established in childhood. So he believed that each stage of development, again, was focused on overcoming a conflict. And success or failure in dealing with these conflicts at each stage can impact overall functioning of the person. And he proposed a theory that had 8 stages, which we'll take a look at a little later. So in each stage, people face new challenges, and the stage's outcome depends on how people handle these challenges. The next person was Lev Vygotsky, who is a Russian theorist. And what Lev said and developed was the socio-cultural or cognitive development theory. So, socio-cultural. Now, it's heavily influenced by cognitive development. And what Vygotsky believed was that children learn actively and through hands-on experiences. So, it's an active process through which we develop. And its socio-cultural theory suggests that parents, caregivers, peers, cultural beliefs, attitudes, and language are all responsible for the development of this higher order function of learning. And he said that a child internalizes the information they get from the interaction with others. So he was all about how us as individuals are influenced by those around us and the culture around us. And that is, that interaction is what is able to guide children in their own performance and in their own development. And his theory stresses this importance of social interaction in the development of cognition. So, fun fact, unfortunately, Vygotsky died at the age of 38, so many of the parts of his theory were actually incomplete. And the last theorist we're going to take a look at was Lawrence Kohlberg, and he developed the moral development theory. So he looked at how we develop our morals throughout life. He focused on moral reasoning, or why people think about the difference between right and wrong. So right versus wrong. He believed that moral reasoning depends on the level of cognitive development and proposed that people pass through three levels of moral development. So his was three stages, but each of these three stages was further divided into two stages. So altogether, there were six levels. And he came up with this theory after he did a lot of research with groups of children. So he would present these children with a bunch of moral dilemma situations, and then after, he would interview the kids to find out their reasoning behind their judgments in each of the scenarios. So he'd ask them a bunch of questions and try to analyze how they came to certain conclusions and reasoning behind how they solved each of these scenarios. So overall, remember that Freud and Erikson looked at personality. So they were focused on how personality develops, versus Vygotsky and Kohlberg were interested in how our cognition develops. So their theories were heavily influenced by cognitive theories. So this is a broad overview of the different stages of development from four main in different perspectives. There are a lot of other and many more perspectives, but we're going to focus on these four. And so the main takeaway from this is to keep in mind the similarities and differences, as well as the focus of each of the theories. And in the next set of videos, I'll go into more depth into each one of these theories.